Hey guys, it's Jonathan from Bullet Motorsports. Right next to me, we have a 1956 Chrysler Imperial. It's rust-free, documentation since 1956. We've got about 15 cars going up live on our site, so be sure to like and subscribe so you can see them pop up. We have from military rib boats, eight-wheeled vehicles. We have a S2000 CR with 30,000 miles. We've got a 348 TS, which is a 91, with $16,000 in receipts from January. A lifted Jeep that's turbocharged. We've got a ton of cool stuff. Even a smart car if I decide to sell it, but I've been driving that. So let's get back to this specific car. I'm gonna start off with the engine bay on this 56. By the way, I've been driving this for 2 weeks as a daily driver. Runs and drives excellent. You can literally jump in it, and it starts up like that every time. I didn't give it any gas. Let's open up the hood. It's running right now, by the way. Let's open it up. Look at how cool this badge is. That's when they made badges in the 50s and 60s. Imperial. So it's powered by 354 Chrysler Hemi. Look how big that motor is. Runs and drives excellent. Transmission shifts perfect. It has a push button transmission. Radiator has been recored. All the suspension feels good. This was a factory AC car, so the air conditioning unit was actually in the trunk and all the lines run on the passenger side frame rail. It does have power brakes. It runs great, and what's really cool, stand back, you got to hear this horn. Whoa. Let me turn it off and we'll keep on talking about the chrome and the paint condition. All the doors close with, like, yeah, that's right, I'm solid steel. So the chrome is original, so there's gonna be a little bit of pitting. It does have the signature dual snout with your Chrysler emblem right here. Obviously, you're gonna see some imperfections on the chrome because it's original. The grille itself is beautiful, but you do see that there is a little bit of oxidation here. So we started to wipe this down and it actually cleans up, but you know, it's from 1956. Beautiful crest right here. All the lights work as they should. Paint, I would say 6.5 out of 10, 7 out of 10, very nice. Brand new coker white walls with the Imperial caps. You do have an antenna here. Radio does not work, so what I do is I bring a little Bluetooth box. I bought it on Amazon, $39. Probably sound better than any speaker in here anyways. The door handles open up like this. Original carpet and headliner, and I believe interior from what I can see. It does have power seats, and they still work. This was like the ultimate business coupe. You do have your push button right here. It works properly. The gauges are in excellent condition. They all work too. Dash is really nice. The pad's really nice. All your power windows operate. That's right, power windows. There is one small imperfection on the rear passenger glass. It's a small crack. I did not get a quote to price that. We're gonna sell it as it sits. All right, let's open up the rear door now. What's really cool about this is it does have the fold-out windows. So, you have air coming from here, and you have air coming from here. So it's like full-blown aeration. That's probably because everybody smoked back then. Open up the door. Rear seats are nice. They're very comfortable. A lot of room in here. You can open this up, and you have an armrest. It's comfortable. You've got your grab handles here. Headliner is 100% original, and it is showing its age for sure. We tried to clean it, but it's too delicate, so it's gonna stay just like that. I will include my fuzzy dice. You do have the air conditioned unit back here, and it's still in place, so you could probably get it running. Let me close this and we'll go to the back. Ashtray. This is cool. Look at the taillights. So they're mounted up top. Let me step on one of them. Isn't that neat? All the bright work on the side is original, does show imperfections, but it's extremely nice. You do have your Imperial badging right here. It's just a cool car. It's a big land yacht. A little bit of pitting on the chrome here. Rear bumper is actually in very nice shape. To open the trunk, you put the key in and unlock it. You push the button and you're gonna lift up. This is where the cool stuff comes in. You've got your Chrysler air temp car cooling system. Right now I have the vents closed, but that's where the air would actually come in. There's vents up here and the air would get pushed in, and then it would get the, basically the condenser up front would cool it down and it would shoot it up into the cabin. Got a whole bunch of books here, documentation. What's really neat, look at this. Dealer's report of sale, 1956 from California. So I want you to look in our gallery. You're gonna see underneath here, extremely dry, extremely clean. All the bushings look good. You can jump in it and drive it. A lot of documentation. We also have all of the state of California receipts for registration, which all the way up to 78. This book right here goes over the history of this 1956 Imperial. The owners were Melody and Charles. So they have all the receipts here. Very neat. And it runs really, really good. You're gonna see when we go for this test drive. You have more registration documentation from the era, along with instructions for the heat and air condition, how to mix your antifreeze, and your Automobile Manufacturers Association documents, along with a bronze award. Very cool. Great job, Mr. and Mrs. Anton. Let's go ahead and close this and go down the passenger side. All the bright work and trim work is really nice on this side too. It is original. Open up the driver's side door. You're gonna see that crack here. I said it's a small crack, but I was corrected that it is a large crack. But the window does go up and down easily. It's a two pane glass. All the windows go up and down like that. Let's open up this door here. So you see all the lights are still operating inside as well. Your dash lights are working. Imperial giant right there on that footwell. I'm gonna start it up so you can hear the exhaust, and then we're gonna take it for a ride. Hopefully you got, oh, look at the roof. Look at how beautiful that is. Not a dent or ding. Let's fire it off again. Super quiet, no smoke. We do run a high test in here because of the engine. It sounds good. Let's go for a ride. Also, I want to show you guys my shirt that I'm wearing. This is our ride or die shirt. If you buy this shirt, you buy $60 worth of merchandise, you're gonna get the sticker pack, which is right here, and free shipping. These shirts run $29.95 a piece. They're dry fit, and the ones we have for you guys are cotton. Mine are dry fit because it's special, but let's go. We're sitting inside right now. I do have it on. Just fire it off. Starts right up. You have your emergency brake right here. You do have your light controls, and it does operate. Wipers operate too. I've driven this car in the rain. You have your lighter, which is definitely a signature for the Imperial. And it's actually in pretty good shape. Casico made it. You got your panel lights, which will be the lights in here. And then you get your map light, which still operates. Radio, it actually does click on, but I'm not getting any signal. And you have the town and country. How cool is that? So it's searching for it. I think with a little bit of work, you could probably get this thing working. Clock is right there and it does operate. Yeah, that's right. You see that movement? Glove box. All right, so I'm gonna take the emergency brake off, put it into reverse. It's not gonna bang into gear. It's really smooth. We're at operating temperature now, so you can see that the temperature gauge moved. Our fuel gauge is working, our oil pressure gauge is working, voltage is working, speedometer, showing 84,000 miles. That could or could not be true, but I think based on the underside condition and overall condition, most likely it is. Drives really nice, does have a pretty good amount of pep, so once we get on this main road, we'll jump on the highway and get off on Griffin Road. All right, we're jumping onto 95 South right now. Exhaust feels good, transmission shifting properly. Remember, it's got those Coker like bias plies, so you're gonna feel the lanes just like how it was in the, basically in the 60s and 70s. Let me put my window up here. Sorry, that's yours. So you don't have any wind noise. All right, we're getting on to the highway now. I'm just giving it moderate throttle. We are at 55 miles an hour, cruising nicely. Minimal steering, you can turn the steering wheel and it actually tracks the proper direction. We're cruising. But the day before Thanksgiving, it's a perfect car to drive around on Thanksgiving Day. I might take it home. Brakes feel good too, so remember they have power assist. So when we get off, you're gonna see that I'm gonna touch the brakes and it stops. It doesn't pull left or right. It's just a nice sorted car. If you guys have any questions about this specific Imperial or any of our inventory, please give us a call at 954-363-2261. Also, if you wanna do a shipping quote, just go to our transport tab and you can find out what it'll cost to get it to your zip code or your port of entry. This is cool. We are in a land yacht right now. Also, if you want to finance this, I can get you guys financed. We use three great lenders, JJ Best Bank, Woodside Credit, and Classic Car Lending. I do prefer JJ Best Bank because I have a really good relationship with them, but any of those will work. It's great to shop your interest rates. You have to have a credit score of over 700 in order for those to work because this is a classic car, not a new car. We're just getting off the highway. I just turned my turn indicator on, turn signal. You can see it's flashing on the dash. The dash is really, really nice in this car. Here we go. Nice and smooth. Let's give it some gas and see what she does. Wow, this is fast. It's like that movie Porky's. I watched that last night and they had all these 50s cars like sliding around, and then they even tore down a like this brothel with a tow truck from the 50s. Pretty neat. Let's get some outside shots. You guys can make your decision on if this is the right car for you. Once again, 954-363-2261. We have a great rating. We've sold cars for 10 years, only classic cars, over 1,200 sold. Thanks again.